Information literate learners are able to integrate multiple information sources, often with different points of view, to support an idea, opinion, conclusion, or a solution to a problem. This is called synthesizing information. During research, information synthesis doesn't usually occur all at one time, but really throughout the process. It's easy to think of research as a linear or straightforward process, but in reality, it's really quite messy. There are certain steps, such as choosing a topic, finding the information, reading the information, synthesizing or integrating the information into a paper, and writing a final draft. But really, as you read information, your topic or research question might change. You might find information that doesn't get read, and you will read information that you don't use. And as you read, you will return to searching. It creates a visual that's much more dynamic than originally depicted. But synthesis of information does largely occur after you have gathered some sources of information. You have listened to the conversation, read arguments and ideas from experts on the topic. Now it's your turn to jump in. As you write a paper or develop a project, you are likely guided by a research question and perhaps have a thesis statement, a position that you are arguing or seeking to support. All of the sources used in your project should relate back to your thesis in some way, either supporting your point or offering an alternative perspective. It's your job to use these sources to support your central point. It is not enough to simply present sources. Synthesizing means that you also present your own ideas and responses as they relate to those sources. Because you are joining the conversation, it becomes your responsibility to tie your voice in with others who have preceded you in this discussion. You didn't develop your ideas out of thin air, but they came to you based on what others have said.